not the biggest fan of winter. The sun sets at like 4 p.m. It's freezing cold outside, and my lips get so dry. And I've tried to fight this problem by buying a seemingly endless variety of lip products. All of these things I just pulled out of my purse. No one needs this many lip products. I have this much lip skin. And with all the products that I carry, you'd think I'd have found my solution by now. But no, I just keep reaching for new products, convinced they'll fix my lips. But that stops today. I'm done with overbuying and wasting my money on things that don't work. So in this video, we're uncovering the science of lip care, speaking to both a dermatologist and a cosmetic scientist, and trying different lip products to figure out once and for all if lip balms are just a scam.
I don't really feel good about this one.
Thank you to Vessi for sponsoring a portion of today's video, and to our patrons for supporting the channel. Do you guys ever experience chapped lips? Do you ever get chapped lips?
Yes, until I developed my system.
Show us them lips.
They look pretty
non-chapped. Wow, those actually look mega healthy.
What's your secret?
I am going to sound like a conspiracy theorist. Lip skin, that's just skin, right? How did Big Lip Balm convince us that moisturizing with normal moisturizer on your lips is not normal? I use my moisturizer on my lips for moisture. Then I take my lip balm and I put that on top for protection.
What type of lip balm is it?
I use this drunk elephant lip balm.
That's so slay of you.
What is the level
she
of
she just doesn't care about my answer. That's crazy.
The proof is in the pudding, actually. Have you seen how unchapped my lips are?
What are you trying to say right now?
Okay, Sabrina, what's your theory?
I also have a two-part system. To moisturize, I just stay hydrated. I just drink water. To keep it glistening and gorgeous, hamburger.
You're so annoying. What do you mean?
A little bit of grease. A little bit of greasy food. We got two ends of the spectrum. Just drinking water or just moisturizing. Who's right, Melissa?
I'm gonna figure this out. I'm gonna get hydrated, healthy lips, and I'll prove both of you wrong.
What do you mean both of us wrong? I'm right.
No, I'm right.
Now, each of them have pretty different approaches to treating their chapped lips. And you know, I see what both of them are saying. One challenge is getting our lips moisturized, and the other is keeping them that way. But how do we actually do that? I think the secret formula lies in here, the ingredients list. My theory is that a lip balm with actual hydrating ingredients will, one, make my lips feel soft, and two, mean that I need to reapply it less throughout the day. So to test my theory, I'm gonna do an experiment where I try out 5 different lip balms with varying ingredients and formulas to figure out which one works the best. The winner will have the least amount of applications per day and will leave my lips feeling soft, hydrated, and not chapped. There's an overwhelming amount of lip products on the market. So for the sake of this experiment, I'm gonna set some guidelines for myself. I'm only considering products that are categorized as lip balms, so no glosses or oils. They need to be clear, so no color. And lastly, they need to be fragrance-free. I try to avoid fragrance in all of my skincare products because I have sensitive skin and eczema, so I'd imagine that the same applies for my lip skin. I'll admit, in the past, I've been a little impulsive with my lip product purchases, not really reading the ingredients and buying them mostly based on cute packaging. But now it's time for a more thoughtful approach. When I was reading through ingredient lists of each product, I was looking for familiar hydrating ingredients that I find in the rest of my skincare. Ingredients like shea butter, hyaluronic acid, squalene, and jojoba oil, to name a few. So after scouring the internet, here's the 5 that I landed on. Some products I chose because I've already used other products from that brand, and others I've seen online and honestly really wanted to test the hype around them. Each day I just used 1 product, and I counted how many times I needed to reapply and tried to take note of how I felt throughout the day. Making sure to go outside at least once a day, because I needed to know if these products could stand up to the cold. Now, the reason I'm doing this experiment is because I don't want my lips to be dry. But the one thing I do want to keep dry, especially in the winter, are my feet. I live in the city, it gets cold and wet here, and I'll be honest, I don't love wearing boots, except for these heels, but they're not the most practical. Most of the time, I usually just wear sneakers, even in the winter. Do my feet get cold? Yeah. But I think I fixed it because now I've got these. These are my vessies. Totally waterproof, incredibly comfortable, and very versatile. I have these Stormburst low tops in white, and they've quickly become my go-to shoes for almost any occasion where I need to go and run out the house. Whether I'm grabbing coffee, running errands around the city, or taking a walk with my dog. I know my feet will stay dry and comfortable no matter the weather. I do know someone who insists on wearing athletic shoes, even in the winter. I get it. Sometimes you just don't want to deal with the hassle of heavy boots or lacing up something bulky. I've been there myself. But honestly, since switching to vessi, I've seen the light. Or rather, the dry. So this holiday season, if you're looking for a thoughtful gift for your loved ones, maybe surprise them with a gift that keeps them warm and dry. You can shop vessi's waterproof collection at vessi.com for only $99. Style, comfort, and versatility all in one. Now, back to lip balms.
All right, I have completed my experiment, and I'm here to report back with my findings. These first two, I was like so excited to try them. And these are the ones that I realized after using them for two whole days that they did in fact have fragrance in them. Oopsies. The first day I used the Ilia Lip Wrap Reviving Balm. The formula is a tube. It looks like that. And its highlighted ingredients are squalene, castor seed oil, and shea butter. It smells kind of minty. Like if you put a mint in a coffee shop and left it there. I was really excited about this one because I use this brand's other products for like skincare and makeup. So I was like, their makeup and other skincare is great. This lip product must be also incredible. But it was honestly underwhelming. This product felt nice when I first applied it. It gave me that like nice glossy feeling. But I remember my lips feeling like almost sticky after wearing it for a few hours. And like I wanted to reapply it to avoid that sticky feeling that I had. It almost felt like I had a layer of something extra on my skin that wasn't pleasant. When I move my mouth, I just don't want to feel like I have something on my lips. I just want them to feel like they blend in and are just there. This did not do that for me. So on to the next one. This is the Fresh Sugar Advanced Therapy Lip Treatment. I don't think I know the difference between a lip balm and a lip treatment, and now that I think about it, it might just be marketing. This formula is in a stick. It's got a beeswax base, and its highlighted ingredients are hyaluronic acid and jojoba oil. I applied this a total of 4 times this day, and also realized too late that there was fragrance in here. I remember needing to reapply it a lot throughout the day, because when you do apply this product to your lips, it feels really comfortable and cushiony, but the formula is so thin, I just wanted to keep layering. This product did an okay job at making my lips feel good. I was just disappointed that I needed to put it on so many times throughout the day. The next product is the Rode Peptide Lip Treatment. This formula is in a tube, and it's got a polyisobutene as a base, and it's got shea butter along with a whole bunch of other hydrating ingredients.
Oh, this one.
This is the one that I got the most influenced to buy, I will admit. When I first put this on, glossy dream. Oh my goodness, Miss Bieber.
My lips? They feel wonderful.
Something that was interesting about this one is that it didn't leave my lips with that sticky feeling. So when I did want to reapply this lip product, it wasn't because my lips felt bad. It was just because the product had evaporated and I wanted to put it back on. I think the only downside to this one is that I'm wondering if I had actually truly chapped lips. I don't know how it would have performed if I had like flakes, you know? The next product is the La Roche-Posay Cicaplast Lèvres. It's French, so it's lip. Cicaplast Lip. The ingredient highlights are triglycerides, shea butter again.
This balm, it's so thick.
This product, when I apply it, it feels greasy on my lips, but it just feels like something is sitting on top of them. Is it doing anything? And I thought that it would have, because it's got like ceramides or whatever in here and like skin repairing. So I don't know if it's doing any repairing. I reapplied this for a total of 5 times in the day. Yeah, this is one that I ended up having to reapply the most amount of times. It's fine. If I were to compare it to the fresh one, both of these products have the same kind of greasy, slippery feeling when I put them on my lips, but the fresh one felt like it was hydrating versus this one just felt like it was sitting on top of my skin. And then our final one. This is Blistex. This is in a stick formula, and the ingredient highlights are menthol, camphor, and it's got a beeswax base. This is one that I have never sought out to purchase myself. It was in my parents' home, and I took it. And this is also something you can find at like any drugstore. Out of all the products, this one was the most surprising for a couple of reasons. I was very skeptical that this one was going to work.
I don't really feel good about this one. There's menthol and alcohol in it, pretty sure. That makes my lips worse.
It makes my lips feel tingly and numb.
I don't think I like this one.
When you first put this on and you go outside, it feels terrible.
I just walked outside to get into the car and my lips are so cold. It's cold outside, but I think because of the menthol. You know, you have when you like eat a mint and then drink water, it just like is icy cold.
And for that reason, I was hesitant to keep on reapplying it throughout the day.
I don't know how long I can use this one for.
But then,
guys, they feel like a new lip has been reborn. And I don't want to reapply.
Maybe I don't need to reapply it because my lips actually feel fine. Why does the most gross one work? All of these products, around $20. $2?
Why would I buy these things if the $2 product works?
Well, I do know because this is ugly. This product doesn't deliver the gloss of the Rode one or the Ilia one, but it sure as heck does unchap my lips. I'm just confused here. What is making this work and these not work?
So to find some clarity, I spoke to both a cosmetic chemist and a dermatologist to help me figure out where I was going wrong with my lip care approach.
Chapped lips essentially are the skin of your lips that skin is experiencing an impaired barrier.
Our lip skin is some of the most vulnerable and thin skin on our body. The most outer layer of our skin contains about 15 to 20 layers of skin, compared to our lips, which only has about 3 to 5, which not only makes it difficult for our lips to hold on to moisture, but also makes them difficult to treat because of how active our lips are.
Your lips are just in the worst place. So first off, you're breathing on them, and that gets worse in dry weather. So it's like any sort of wind will accelerate that water leaving. You've also got lots of things touching your lips, like water, saliva, food, that's washing that oil away, so it's getting rid of the natural moisturizer.
The transition to fall and winter, that's often when people start presenting with really dry, chapped lips, because whatever products and routine they were using for their lips isn't adequate enough to help trap in that moisture.
I realized that I misunderstood the basics of lip products. I was getting too deep into specific ingredients, not really understanding the 3 larger categories of ingredients that actually determine how a product might feel or perform.
There are occlusives, and these tend to form a seal on your skin and help seal in water. Petrolatum, lanolin.
It's like a bandage. It just allows your skin barrier to repair itself. It helps trap in moisture.
Then we've also got emollients, which are also oils, but these ones don't necessarily seal in water very well. They mostly sort of fill in the gaps in your skin barrier. And then you've also got humectants, which are ingredients that are really good at holding on to water. All 3 types will help with hydration. In general, the one that works the best for your lips are occlusives.
So I guess the reason that Blistex worked for me was that it had the right combination of occlusives, emollients, and humectants for my specific lip needs at the time.
On top of that, there's also just like individual factors like genetics. Some people do produce more oil on their lips and more oil in their skin overall.
There's no right answer, and everybody's different. If you're the type of person that, you know, you can go skiing and you don't need to use chapstick and your lips feel comfortable, they feel fine, you don't need to use anything.
Products that are not in a stick form tend to do better, partly because it's easier to apply a really thick layer, and partly because the ingredients that are needed to make a stick work, that's a lot harder to formulate than it is to make a goo. So yeah, I think goo products generally tend to work better for that, even though they are like a bit of a pain to apply when you're out.
Should I stop buying lip balms?
Well, maybe the problem all along wasn't my lips, just the fact that I am a consumer and get mesmerized by pretty packaging and marketing.
So I'll definitely be giving some of these away to my mom and my sister. I learned so much talking to both Dr. Michelle and Dr. Aegean, and I couldn't fit all of that information into this video. So if you're interested in listening to both of those full conversations, we'll have both of those available in our next newsletter. Something important that I've really learned is to separate the effectiveness from the glossiness of a product. And I don't mean glossiness just in like the physical aesthetics of the product. I mean all of the marketing and packaging and lifestyle. That doesn't mean that they do the job better. This product, it looks whatever, it's just chapstick. But
It's the thing that worked and unchapped my lips. While this doesn't give me that really glossy, beautiful look, it's something that works for me. There is a wide spectrum of lip. There's no one product solution for everyone. We all have different lip conditions, lip sensitivities, and different preferences for what we want our lips to look and feel like. Sometimes I need to just heal chapped lips. Sometimes my lips are healthy and I want something glossy. I mean, it's still fun to have fun with lip care if you want to. Just don't go overboard, Melissa. This is a message for you in the future when you rewatch this video a year from now and your lips get chapped again. Rewatch this video and remember these three things. One, you are allergic to fragrances. Stop buying products with fragrance in them. Two, what do your lips actually need? Do you just want a lip gloss? Do you just need to unchap your lips? These are two different products, Melissa. Three, sometimes the cheap thing is the thing that's gonna work. Why is the cheapest one the one that worked? So mad. Good night.